Well, here we go again with yet another BBC video. Well, here we are again talking about the BBC again. In the last few weeks, so we've actually released the BBC videos on the documentary Who Decides, and we're talking about the BBC yet again. It does make me feel somewhat sad that we're discussing the same type of topics again. It does seem to be the BBC have got something in for the trans community, yet with only a year or two ago, they'd be doing some great documentaries covering Swansea Sparkle, so it does seem somewhat schizophrenic in their decisions over how they cover trans topics, positive and negative, and in this particular discussion, it regarding Jenni Murray. They are independent, but they do represent a big key part of Woman's Hour, so they are a significant figure, and of course they do have an OBE, so of course they do carry some weight. And some of the things that are being said is that they have a responsibility in how they cover topics, and it does seem to me their personal opinion is being touted as fact. I mean, the first time when I heard about this news, I wasn't angry like some people were, rightly so, have to be said. I just thought this is incredibly cynical. I was right, but I was also wrong in the respect that I thought she'd be releasing a book. She wanted to get some press for the book, so she'd take this controversial subject and launch the book. But what I didn't immediately connect until, obviously, it was the 8th, was it was International Women's Day. So even though I think they predicted that they would be silenced, in inverted commas, because of their controversial topics, but it was in conjunction with that, so it's a very cynical ploy to get their point across. Now, I do not agree that they should be sacked from their position, but I do think we do need to discuss these topics more fully, because they are derogatory in my own personal opinion. And this is what I will discuss in the video, is how I feel that we do need to talk about these topics more openly. The two key arguments put forward by Jenni Murray were related around biological women and biological men, and the second one was of male privilege. So the first one saying that, well, trans women are not real women, and the second topic was regarding male privilege. So you're discussing here things like, well, someone may have transitioned later in life, so they've had many years of male privilege, therefore they've had those benefits, and because of those two things, that the trans community couldn't identify as women or men, but would have to identify as trans man or trans woman. And of course, this has created a very big division and a kind of very big separation, and of course a lot of controversy has come alongside it. Speaking to one of my friends about the topic, who I deeply respect, there was a lot of case of past history, and I did wonder if this was playing a role as well. So you're talking about like things like feminism in the 80s, where you had very much a male-hating attitude, and feminists whom I identify as heterosexual. Therefore, or no, they are in a relationship with a man or they're married to a man, therefore they cannot be a real feminist. And I think this has created a lot of historical discord in the past between the masculine and the feminine, where within more modern circles, things are being more discussed more openly and looked at from those different perspectives. And there was very big fights back then. I'm certainly not going to take that away from them. And a lot of work has been done to at least approach equality between those gender identities. The thing I find really sad, though, is I don't see trans and the trans umbrella being against feminine and equality. I see them actually as wanting to work together, but the division that's being created here is wanting to separate them, and that's what I find really sad. I do think there was somewhat of a martyr play as well, if I was also to be deeply cynical, where they knew that their opinions would be silenced, therefore they made their statement. Obviously the BBC reacted, because the BBC have already had some damaging press anyway because of their documentary. I mean, it's one of the most recent ones I can think that I've seen in the last few years, which was just so poorly researched and so poorly represented, especially when Channel 4 has made some good documentaries, in my own personal opinion, or a lot better than I've seen in previous years. And the BBC has made some years and years ago, which were, I think, a lot more positive. I do feel this very much a regression from the BBC, and this, unfortunately, I think, highlighted the issue, and where the BBC didn't want to have this spotlight on themselves again. But I do think there's a lot of past history going on here which comes into play, and I think the worst thing for me is when you have these divisions over what is right and wrong. By making the statements that Jenni Murray is making, it does appear as if trans women are wrong and genetic women are right. Therefore, within the trans community, even though she stated she didn't want to have hate, she does perpetuate that feeling of hate and to create that divide where a lot of people, I think, are wanting to pull things together rather than to separate and progress, in my own personal opinion. What I find with a lot of these arguments, especially the biological side of the argument as well, is they're just very, very old lines of thinking, which modern science is disproving or at least questioning. So a lot of people think, well, okay, you're a boy, then you have one set of chromosomes, you're a girl, you have another set of chromosomes, where science is questioning those very basis. Yes, they can have a driver towards your gender, but there's also things like womb development, which can also have a heavy bearing on the gender or the personality of the child. So it is highly likely you can have someone that might be XY, but through the hormone washes throughout the whole pregnancy, bear in mind pregnancy is 9 months, that they may have more predominantly feminine hormones. Therefore, the brain structure would be more aligned with female than a male identity. And this then ties into things like biological brain research, which has also questioned that you have a male or female brain, but you have a spectrum from where these can reside. So you don't have someone who's genetically just male or just female, you can have someone along these spectrums. So I find that these, oh no, they have one set of gender at birth, or one set of genitalia, whatever, is very, very binary and pixelated in a very colourful and varied world. And it's almost like they want to renounce the diversity which has already been established in science as apparent, as you would have with evolution in the past. So for my money, I just think these opinions are 30 years out of date. And there's just not the basis to support them. From what I can see, I think it's more to do with perceived encroachment than a biological argument or even a social one where people might transition later. For many cases, that later delayed transition isn't because they didn't want to come out earlier. That might be because of perceived rejection from society. That may be because of employment or because of children. It could be for a multitude of reasons. I have spoken to so many different people that have had some certain ceremonies in private because they didn't want to reveal something, or maybe, for example, they didn't want to tell their children because of a certain issue and they were scared of the reactions to that. So then to say that someone may delay to get more male privilege, again, is not having the discussion from the other side of the argument. Yet again, the wanting to pull together is separating those two groups. And I'm not going to say that it is easier to be a woman than to be trans. It's just different challenges. And you've got to bear in mind is when you're discussing whether people want to transition or they feel safe if they can transition to do so, those things have to be bared in mind. And then to point them out as someone extracting more male privilege is very cynical indeed. And it's not listening. And this is the thing that I come back to, is that they're blocking that discussion. I think it's a real big shame. A big push at the moment is to actually challenge why we have gender identities at all in that strict male and female sense, that you have a male gender role, you have a female gender role, therefore you have to act to X role or to Y role, where there's not any roles at all. These are all created by society. I'm not saying that some sort of biological hormones can't have an impact on brain development. They can do, as has been shown in the previous research. But it's not a binary yes or no for are they male or female. Everything lies on a spectrum. And this ties into the next point I was going to make. No one can speak for your experiences as a human being than you. I cannot represent the whole of the trans community. I cannot represent all the LGBT community. No one has the power to speak for everyone within that group. I know there's so many different female friends that I've got that would have varied interests, from playing computer games to talking about fashion. There is nothing wrong with any of that, but you have different personalities. And that's, again, part of being human. You have these variances, and it's about breaking down those barriers. There's some very good male friends that I've had which have some more effeminate qualities, and society will then place pressure on them and judge them because they're not male enough. And who said who should be more male or less male. It's all rubbish. It's all rubbish in my personal opinion. It's about accepting and embracing everyone for who they are. And every time someone tries to make a division, say, oh no, they're not really trans, or they're not this, or they're not that, just exacerbates and then further separates rather than bringing things together. The trans community is actually very impassionate about getting equality, not just for the trans community, but for society as a whole, because we experience ourselves discrimination, whether that's employment, housing, relationships, social environments, the list just goes on and on and on and on, because we are prejudged about who we are, but sometimes before we even walk in the door in some situations. And this still happens today, not in all cases, not with all companies, not with all housing associations, but I still deal with those issues on a daily basis. So we can speak at least from our own experiences of being discriminated against. And of course, when we go for jobs, I know so many trans people who have either lost their job or had gone down in income because they had to go for a different position because their original position fired them. So we know about employment inequality as well. But what I see a lot of people wanting to do is breaking down those gender stereotypes, breaking down those social stereotypes about how male and females should behave because of arbitrary rules which are just created by society. We are not controlled by them, but we let them control us. That's why a lot of the trans community are very passionate about opening up what it means to be a gender role, rather than trying to close it down and close down and shut off the conversation, which I feel, coming back to the original statements, that these points are trying to do. They're trying to cut off the situation, say, we have men and you have females, and this is what I find is really difficult, is we're both speaking from different perspectives, but we're both being discriminated against. And we want to actually make things better for everybody, rather than just try to separate and divide. I want to apologise that it's more than 2 minutes long, because I know this topic is really fresh. I wanted to get my opinion out there. Now, a lot of people have said their opinion, and I mean, so things like Kate on the BBC social at least give me some spark of hope the BBC might have some decency left. But what I really want to finish with here is that going forwards, what I hope is we can have some open discussion rather than doors being closed. And that's what I feel is being happening here. I think no one is saying that females don't have a right and a privilege to feel they are valued and equally appreciated in society. And I honestly believe that needs to happen. But at the same time, creating yet other divisions and topics and boxes to try to separate, I don't think helps any. And to be perfectly frank, the evidence that goes behind that thinking is out of date. In my own personal opinion, it's just something that's in the past. And a lot of it, I think, is to do with previous hatred and stereotyping of the feminist community from other aspects in the past, as much as the trans community has come on fire from other sources that maybe don't see trans as a gender identity. And I'm not trying to say that people can't identify how they want to. Some trans people identify as male or female, and they say, well, now my body matches my head, therefore I am that gender. And I think we need to be a lot more embracing and accepting of people as they are, and to welcome them rather than to look for reasons to discriminate and separate. So I'm sorry this is another serious video. I do have some makeup reviews on the way, so I hope you can go a lot more lighthearted. And I am trying to work on some other series and some other aspects in the future. So, as always, thank you very much for watching. I do really appreciate your support. If you do have any other ideas or any other topics you would like me to cover, let me know. I'm always open to new product reviews or open to new topics you want to discuss. Maybe you want to even have a Q&A. Whatever. Drop me a line. You'll have all the emails and Twitters and all the rest of that, which I always check on a regular basis. So, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you don't have to do another one on the BBC yet again. I'm not confident. Anyway, thank you. Goodbye, and please subscribe.